I'm at one of my favorite fossil hunting locations today in Florida, and I have brought my fiance, Kat, along with me. And we have been looking for recently exposed Ice Age formation, and we have found a bunch. We just had a hurricane come through, and we are really hopeful that these recent exposures of these Ice Age deposits will yield some cool fossils. So we're gonna get our dive gear ready, our masks on, and we're gonna start diving, and I'm really hopeful that we might find either a mammoth tooth, a mastodon tooth, or some kind of extinct animal fossil today. So stay tuned as we get underwater. Now, what Kat doesn't know is I've actually brought her along as gator bait. So normally I'm out here by myself and I gotta worry about the alligators, but I've got someone smaller and cuter, and I think the gators will go after her instead of me. What, are you scared now?
Something touched my foot.
Now, of all the rivers I hunt, this one seems to have the fewest gators, but that first time you get underwater and you get in to the unknown, you really don't know what's in there, and hopefully it's fossils.
All right.
How's it look?
There's gravel. So there was a channel of gravel, including this first piece of bone. Kat's about to join me, and we'll find the start of this channel. And this is a really good sign. There might be something here. If not, we got all day to crawl in the bottom of this river.
Cold and I'm blind.
Well, you've got prescription and goggles, so you'll be just fine.
Oh, it's so cold.
Come on, you gotta find fossils. You can't start, you can't bail out now. You got this.
You're also like a foot taller than me.
Just a little bit. All right, tag teaming it. Let's do it. Three,
I'm
two,
not
one.
Kidding.
Piece of a Meg.
Yeah.
Oh, look at how sharp the serrations are, though.
Am I breathing too much?
No, you're breathing fine. Breathe. So I figured you guys would have a hard time telling what this was underwater, so I got out to film it. This is an extinct Chubutensis shark tooth. This is the shark that evolved into Megalodon. And if you look closely where my thumbnail is pointing at, you'll see a group of raised serrations. That's a vestigial feature called a cusp or cusplet, and they had that to catch fish. Now that feature evolved away by the time Megalodon was a species, and that's because Megalodon was so big that even its babies did not need to hunt fish. They were already capable to hunt cetaceans and mammals. So that's a really cool find. Typically you don't find it here because the river does not erode deep enough to get this kind of geologic unit, but I love finding them, and that is a cool shark tooth. I did not expect that to be fossilized, but it is.
Wow, yeah, it's heavy.
That's a big bone.
Bonk.
Sweet.
So there is so much bone in this gravel bed here. I'm literally just sticking my hand in the water and picking up pieces of bone. And I happen to pick up this cool horse incisor.
It is unbelievable the amount of diversity that is in this bin. I have still have a little bit left to hunt, but after that I'm gonna crawl out of the river and show you the cool fossils that we've already managed to find today. All right, we are out of the water for the first time today. And yeah, we found a ton of bone. This spot was loaded with a bunch of different species. We've got extinct horse, we've got mastodon, we have gator vertebrae and gator teeth, and Kat even found her own extinct horse incisor. We've got giant bison bones. Like, this spot was absolutely loaded with different animals, though the coolest have to be all of these remnants of extinct horse teeth. Unfortunately, we did not get here in time to save all of these teeth, but we did get two very nice and very beautiful incisors. So these would have been those front teeth that the horse had. This one's actually unerupted, and I love that orange coloration. It's really beautiful. So these are related to the modern day horses, but they're not from the same descent as the European horses. They were kind of halfway between a zebra and a modern horse, but in the same genus, Equus. They went extinct at the end of the Ice Age. Before we jump back in the water, I did want to show you guys three more things. This is a deer antler, a fossilized deer antler. This thing is solid rock now. I'm not joking. Ow. This thing is solid. Like, seriously, this is solid rock.
Then we have this heartbreaker of a mastodon tooth that really could have been something special. I saw it underwater from the ivory side like this, but I already knew what it was, and I flipped it over and was so mad that this thing wasn't whole. But that's what happens out here. Most of the stuff you find is broken, and we've got to save these pieces before they get destroyed. And then this, we find a lot of modern bones when we're hunting. Not that this would be a modern cow bone, but it's well fossilized, well mineralized, and it's probably bison, but we'll have to do a bit of research on this one to figure out what it is. And these were a nice teaser, and I am ready to get back underwater for sure.
Are you ready to start hiking again?
No.
You don't want to hike?
No.
Why?
Because sitting's so much better.
And we're heading to a different area to find more fossils. This place is awesome, and we will get lots and lots of rocks to share with you guys. So when we check new bins like this, the first thing we do is we check the bank, and we see if any gators have left a slide, gator slide, going into the water. This spot doesn't have one, so we're gonna get in here and see if we can't find some fossils.
Had to show you guys a better look at that giant armadillo scute I just found. This is an osteoderm, meaning bony skin in Latin, and it's a protective plate to a giant armadillo. So you don't find a lot of these, at least from this position, and I think it's really cool to find these protective armor. But we gotta get back underwater, gotta keep looking, there's more fossils to find. This bend did not have nearly as much fossil bone as the last bend, but I got lucky and recovered this incredible example of an extinct llama or camel tooth. It's a rearmost molar from that individual, and it is fully rooted, which is so rare.
absolutely a really cool fossil, but we have to keep hiking and find new spots to find more fossils.
We've got some gear stashed with our lunches, and we'll eat that, get back underwater, and keep finding more cool stuff.
River Monster's on the prowl. He's on the hunt for ancient animals, long dead and almost lost to time.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Break a leg.
No.
Don't get eaten by a gator.
It's only happened once before.
No rest for the wicked. Time to get back underwater and do some more fossil hunting.
All right, this is super cool. These are all associated extinct horse teeth from the same animal. So, like we were finding earlier, these are extinct Ice Age horses, closely related to zebras and the European horse, but from a different lineage. And we found 7 teeth, all from the same animal. We got 2 small incisors over here, and then we had a large, I'm sinking into the clay. There are those incisors. The preservation on those teeth are really incredible. They'll definitely stay in my personal collection for a while because you do not find sets like that often. I still have a little bit more to hunt, and hopefully we'll be able to find something really cool before we have to go home today. All right, guys, right in front of those horse teeth was a giant mammoth tooth. It's like 80 to 90% there. I'm freaking out a little bit. I haven't found a mammoth tooth in a really long time, and this looks to be a really nice one from a full-grown adult. So I'm gonna set this camera up on a fallen log, get back underwater, fan it out, and bring it to you guys, and you won't believe how large these animals' teeth are. So I'm excited to do this, and I'm gonna get back underwater.
Finish fanning the tooth out, and it's time to pick it up.
That's a mammoth tooth. Absolutely. Whoo. Oh, it's a little bit deep over here. That is good. That's so cool. Now what's crazy is this thing was literally right in front of that associated set of horse teeth that we found earlier. This is an adult mammoth tooth, full-grown individual. It's a shame that it's missing this tiny portion up here, though. Like, that is killing me. That is one awesome tooth. Now, mammoths are grazers, and because of that, they have these enamel plates cemented together with cementum and dentine in between the enamel. And this is the perfect surface for grinding down over 400, 500 pounds of grass every single day. You'll find that other grazers also have this kind of strategy where having these squiggly enamel plates allow them to grind down grass. And in the mastodon teeth that we normally find, the mastodon tooth chunk that we found earlier, they're lophodont teeth. Their teeth are like ours, and that's because they were browsers. So they were very similar looking animals, except for when it came down to their teeth, and that told you a lot about what these animals ate. And it's funny, how I found this thing is I've got this strategy when it's a little bit dark and there's a bunch of peat. I poke my dive light into stuff and see if it gives or not. I'm poking, and clink! Got a mammoth tooth.
So yes,
that is really cool. I haven't found a nice one like this in a while. I wonder if that piece that I found next to it, where's my dive bag? Here it is. Goes to it, or it's from a different animal. No, that is not the same tooth. So there could be another tooth in there somewhere, but it looks like if there is, it's been destroyed. But that's really cool. This is the stuff you come out to hunt for. This is the stuff you look for, and this is the reason why we go out to these remote areas that could have gators and all sorts of stuff. This is what we do. This is why we do it. I'm pretty excited. We just got back to our gear, and we have decided that there is no way that we are getting back underwater and looking for more fossils and getting home in time. So we're going to give you guys one last look at the best find from today. And just, you know, a quick little thing, that might be today's best find, but right there, that's the life's best find. That's my future wife, y'all. If you guys did enjoy today's video, please remember to like it, share it, and subscribe to the channel. If you want to see Kat in more videos in the future, please leave a comment down below. And if you do want to learn more about the channel and what we do, go to diggingscience.com, linked in the description below.